unicorns of the sea. They're a real thing and they make me so excited that I might pee myself a little bit. Hello friends, Laci Green here for 4D News. No new studies for you today, just a loving celebration of another neato animal in the sea, the narwhal. This is a rare whale that lives in the Arctic waters with a long horn-like tusk that juts out from its head, a tusk that can grow to be 10 feet long. In addition to the unicorn of the sea, the narwhal has also been referred to as the corpse whale because its spots kind of look like liver mortise, that patchy discoloration that can happen after death, although as the narwhal ages, it gets more and more white. For centuries, the narwhal has been famous not for its color, but for that tusk, which has been the source of all kinds of folklore and legends. It may have been the original inspiration for the beloved fictional unicorn, and people believed the tusk had magical healing powers. They believed it so strongly, in fact, that in the Middle Ages, the tusk of the narwhal was worth 10 times its weight in gold. The high demand has posed a threat to the species, actually, so that's not cool. The source of the narwhal's fame, the tusk, is actually a tooth. The craziest tooth you'll ever see, my friends, and it's the only tooth that the narwhal grows. Although very rarely a second tooth will grow. The tooth is grown by most males and only about 15% of the females. It grows directly through the whale's upper lip and spirals to the left, always to the left, possibly because it helps maintain a more durable structure. And it's not super hard either. The tusk is bendy. It can bend about a foot in any direction. What's interesting about the narwhal's tooth is that its anatomy is basically an inside-out version of a human tooth. While humans have the hard stuff on the outside, protecting the soft sensory tissue on the inside, the narwhal has the hard stuff on the inside with the sensitive layers on the outside. Now there's a reason for the madness. The sensitive layer is covered with millions of tiny holes, which act as a sophisticated sensor for the whale. These holes lead to nerves, which allow the narwhal to sense the water pressure, temperature, how salty it is. Good things to have for survival, which is why it's not clear why female narwhals are less likely to have one. The function of the tusk is still being studied because they're pretty mysterious creatures that are hard for scientists to observe. The scientific consensus at this point is that the tusk is a sexual trait, kind of like a lion's mane. It may be there to attract a mate, to display dominance, or maybe even for communication. Narwhals do touch tusks, but it's not a violent way. That would probably hurt anyway, given how many nerve endings cover the tusk. Can you imagine banging up a sensitive organ? No, thank you. So folks, what's your favorite animal in the sea? Tell me about it, and maybe we'll throw a little love fest for them here on D News. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.